Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, we have discussed turning on methods of SCR. Now in this video, we are going to see commutation methods of SCR. Commutation method are nothing but turning off of an SCR. Now what are the different types of methods or different type of circuits can be used to turn off an SCR, or SCR itself can be turned off as it is own, that we are going to see in this video. So basically, first of all, we have discussed some advantages and disadvantages of SCR. If you remember, we have an advantage of SCR is that turning on of a SCR is a very easy method, but turning off of an SCR is a difficult method, because once it is latched into on state, it is difficult to bring into the blocking state, or you can say off state. So what can be done to switch off the SCR? Because SCR is nothing but switch. We are going to use SCR as a switch, and if it is used for the switching application, it should be turned on and it should be turned off by the time required. So we'll see how it can be turned off. So first of all, the commutation is the process of turning off a conducting SCR is known as a commutation. When it is turned on, we say that SCR is a latched, and IL is important at that time while latching the SCR. When we have discussed VI characteristics, I have told you that latching current is an important parameter while deciding turning on of SCR. But the holding current is an important parameter when you are understanding the turning off process of an SCR. Now, depending on the nature of the source, it can be AC or DC. The commutation can be natural or forced. So first we are going to see how naturally SCR can be turned off, and if not, what can be done to forcibly turn off the conducting SCR. So different techniques, commutation techniques are, first is a natural commutation and forced commutation. Your source can be either AC or it can be DC. If your source is a AC source, it is known as a natural commutation. We have discussed what is natural commutation in the previous video, but we are going to see it again. We have discussed some part of it, how current can come to the zero point naturally. That is what we wanted. If you want SCR to be turned off, what is required is that anode to cathode current should be zero, or it should be below holding current. Once your current comes to the below holding current, your SCR can be turned off. That is the requirement to turn off the SCR. So with the AC source, it is a natural commutation. Natural commutation, that means you don't require any external circuitry or any external device to turn off the SCR. SCR as it is will turn off at one particular point. Forced commutation, whenever we are using a DC source, that time it is difficult to turn off the SCR. So we have to go for the forced commutation. That means forcibly, by using external device or external circuit, you are turning off the SCR. So this mechanism can be either current commutation or this can be a voltage commutation. So this current and voltage is nothing but if you reduce the anode to cathode current below holding current, your SCR will be turned off. This is the first criteria which is to be satisfied to turn off the SCR. Second criteria is that if you provide negative voltage, that is voltage across anode to cathode, if VAK is reversed bias or it is a negative voltage, then your SCR will be turned off. Now let's see. So here first we are going to discuss natural commutation. So natural commutation, I have shown a simple diagram. So this is my SCR, correct? And the load connected is a resistive load, and the source apply is a AC source. Whenever there is a AC source connected to the SCR, SCR can be commutated naturally. Now when it comes as an AC source, I have, this is my input voltage supply. This is my AC source given to the circuitry, and the load resistance, load is a resistive load. Here in this circuit, the current flowing through SCR is same as the current flowing through resistor. Now, let's see. This is my input voltage which is given to the circuit, that is Vm sin omega t. So, the amplitude for this positive will be plus Vm and amplitude of this negative cycle will be minus Vm. And here I have shown the output voltage and the current flowing through the circuit, that is I0. So, this dotted line is I0 and V0 is nothing but the voltage across the resistive load. Now, here for a positive cycle, that is from 0 to pi, when it is a positive half cycle, my SCR, this terminal is an anode, this terminal is a cathode, and this terminal is a gate terminal. Now, here I have considered that my gate terminal is open. At this point, my anode to cathode voltage will be positive. Now, I am providing positive half cycle. In positive half cycle, this point will be connected to the positive terminal of the battery and this point is connected to the negative. That means anode is made positive with respect to cathode. Due to this, my SCR is in a forward blocking mode. Now, whatever is the voltage across SCR, the same voltage will appear across the resistive load because resistor is connected in series with SCR. Voltage across resistor will be similar as a voltage across the SCR. Similarly, current flowing through the resistor R is also the similar as current flowing through SCR. Now, if voltage across SCR will be the positive Vm for a positive half cycle, so my output voltage V0 across resistance will also be the positive Vm. Now, at the same time, current flowing through this SCR and resistor is same. So, this is I have shown the current flowing through with a dotted line. Now, if you see carefully, as we have discussed in an earlier video, when the voltage given to the circuit is reached to the zero point, my current will naturally also reach to the zero point. Because for a positive half cycle, SCR will be forward bias, and for a negative half cycle, SCR will be reversed bias. When a voltage is maximum, output voltage and output current is also maximum. When input voltage reaches to zero, output voltage also reaches to zero, as well as output current will also reaches to zero. While negative half cycle, SCR will be reversed bias. If SCR is a reversed bias, there will be no flow of a current through the circuit. If there is a no flow of current through the circuit, there will be no current flow through the resistor. So, here the current and output voltage will be zero. So, here if current is reduced to zero, that means it is automatically coming below holding current. And if my current is automatically coming below holding current, then my SCR is taking a transition from forward conducting state to forward blocking state. That means it is taking a transition from on state to off state. Because of this circuitry and this diagram, you can clearly understand that this is a natural commutation. Because without using external circuitry, my SCR can be turned off if the forward current is reduced to below holding current. That is how natural commutation takes place. Now, when it comes to the forced commutation. Now, forced commutation can be either a voltage commutation or the current commutation. Only difference now when it comes to the current commutation, it is same as a natural commutation. But here you have to bring your current below holding current by using the external circuit. In natural commutation method, we are not using external circuit, but in a forced commutation, you should have an external circuit which will forcibly bring your current below holding current. So let's see what is current commutation. If SCR is turned off by reducing its anode current below the holding current value, then the commutation is called as a current commutation. That means you should have a circuit which can be connected to the anode to cathode terminal or anode terminal and forcibly provide the reverse current or the negative current. If you provide the negative current, your current through the anode to cathode will automatically bring to the below holding value and your SCR will be turned off. Similarly, voltage commutation, if conducting SCR is turned off by applying a large reverse voltage across it, then the commutation is called as a voltage commutation. I'll explain you with diagram. So in current commutation, so if this is the symbol of SCR having a gate terminal, anode and cathode, you have to provide negative current to the anode terminal so that your IA, that is a forward current, will be reduced below holding current, and then your SCR will be turned off. Whereas in voltage commutation, if you bring VAK, that is a voltage across anode to cathode, to the reverse voltage, or we can say you can use the external circuitry which will provide the negative voltage, that is negative VAK, then it will become a reversed bias. If it will become a negative and positive, then it will become reversed bias and it will automatically come in a off state. So these are the two methods, but this both the phenomenon should be take place by using the external device. So you are using the external device, it is also known as a force commutation. So I hope you have understood what is a natural commutation and what is a force commutation. When it is a natural commutation, no external device is required, but it is a force commutation, external devices required. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Do subscribe to Ekeeda. Thank you.